Some people's destiny is determined from birth. This certainly would apply to royalty or those born into wealthy families. Others can have a hint about what is their destiny through the meaning of the names given to them at birth. Noble Khan is one such person. The former independent senator is widely regarded as a nobleman, possessing characteristics and qualities that speak of his gentility, honesty, honor, patriotism, and impartiality. Noble Khan lives up to his name in every sense of the word. Living up to his name, Brother Noble Salahuddin Ahmad Khan. If noble was enough of a description to aspire to, then his second name, Salahuddin, is even more intriguing. Born into a family of voracious readers, Noble's elder sister, Zatoun, declared at his birth that her new baby brother should be called Salahuddin, after the famed Sultan of Egypt and Syria, who led Islamic crusades into the Middle East. At the time, she was reading The Talisman, written by Sir Walter Scott, about the Crusades. This insight into a family who valued literature and knowledge unfurls a glimpse into the fascinating lineage of Noble Khan. Unlike most East Indians who trace their ancestors through indentured laborers from India, Noble's father, Mahmud Khan, was born in Afghanistan in the 19th century, but as a young man, he migrated to Bhopal, India. From there, he further migrated to Africa, living in Eritrea in Italian Somalia. Showing definite traits of an adventurer, Mahmud left Africa for Europe and lived in Italy for many years before venturing further into the Western Hemisphere, taking up residence in Manaus, Brazil. While living in Brazil for some time, Mahmud was invited to Trinidad by prominent Muslim scholar Sheikh Miha Abdul Aziz. He came, married Shakina, who spoke no English, and they established their home in Rose Hill, Laventil. On March 10, 1937, Noble was born, making him the 13th of 15 children the couple had. Today, Noble still lives in Laventil, a community to which he is extremely devoted. As a child, Noble attended the Rose Hill RC School, went on to Nelson Street Boys RC, and concluded his secondary education at Osman High School in Woodbrook. At the time, entry into prestigious secondary schools were challenging for lower-income students. It also meant that the opportunity to be awarded an exhibition scholarship for tertiary education was limited. But being from a determined family, Noble would go on to achieve certification in accounting via USAID and a diploma in public administration at the University of the West Indies, Mona, Jamaica, in 1973. Career-wise, he would have joined the public service as a clerk in 1956, moved to the position of audit assistant in the Auditor General's Department in the Ministry of Finance, and by 1977 become an auditor and budget analyst in the budget division. Later, as a clerk serving in the Ministry's Finance Committee, Noble Khan would have attended Finance and General Purposes Committee meetings of the executive arm of the government and attended budget debates in the Parliament as part of his duties. In 1989, Noble Khan retired from the public service after a distinguished career. But his professional skill set as an accountant with specific knowledge of public accounting saw him working with the National Carnival Commission in 1997 to bring their accounting into order. So successful was this that he was further engaged by the National Carnival Band Leaders Association to do a similar exercise, which he conducted from 1997 to 2008. At the point of his retirement, Noble Khan engaged more in religious activities. An executive member of the Trinidad Muslim League, Noble represented the Islamic faith on the respected interreligious organization body during the 1990s, at one point serving as president of the IRO in the early 2000s. Noble Khan now had significant prerequisites that would see him being appointed as an independent senator by the President of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago to the Parliament of Trinidad and Tobago. At first, he was appointed by former President Arthur Ray Robinson, and later by current President, His Excellency George Maxwell Richards.
I had contact with Mr. Robinson before, in a professional capacity because I had worked in the budget division. And when the Tobago House of Assembly was established, it was in my professional capacity. I was part of the team that structured the financial imaging of the THA and provided for it from what it was before. And in all during the time that I was there, up to late 1989, I was attached to the section that dealt with the Tobago House budget, and as such, I would have had interface with Mr. Robinson. Also, too, as a president of the country, there are times when we will have to meet as part of the interreligious organization and relate.
The Senate was, in fact, a place where mature discussions took place, unlike the House of Representatives, in which I also served, where it was mainly the cut and thrust of politics. In the Senate, you had that opportunity to really bring to bear the improvement of what took place in the lower house, and Brother Khan did that with a lot of maturity, and he did it with a lot of calm and finesse.
Whenever anyone from the independent bench makes a contribution, it was not under any discipline either of the president himself, who had appointed us, neither by the leader of the opposition, who we refer to as the opposition senators, there are six of them, and neither by the government-appointed senators. So when anyone from the independent bench made a contribution, it was what emerged from themselves and not under the discipline of anyone else. And this is something remarkable within our own constitution. When the time came for Mr. Robinson's time to terminate or to finish, because of the fulfillment of time, and Mr. Max was appointed, Mr. Richards, good. He left everybody, did not, well, there was much cry about people should resign and things like that, but once appointed, and he himself had indicated to us that had anyone resigned, if there was any resignation, he would have put us back. So there again, there is an element of continuity of respect and what one president had selected that overflowed into our next. So there was that continuity based on respect and understanding of constitutional matters.
Brother Noble Khan was very noble in all that he did in the Senate, and he didn't have to really look at bringing his own morality. He had a deep sense of religion, he had a deep sense of community, he had a deep sense of what it took to make a country a better place. And as such, the national pride, dignity, and the way in which he saw the country in the future, using his vast experience of the past, the condition of the present, he looked towards the future, and that is what he brought to the Senate.
Noble Khan served in the Senate in the 7th Parliament from April 5th, 2002 to August 28, 2002, and in the 8th Parliament from October 17, 2002 to September 28, 2007. During his tenure, he contributed to 98 bills and 14 motions, an impressive track record.
At the Parliament, you are dealing with our nation at the highest level, and your disciplines and your training will bring to bear. But that again has to be balanced against what is your perception of what is fair, what is just, what is correct, what is in the current terms that have been referred to as sustained development and the welfare for our nation, and particularly our young and our unborn and our future generations. These, in my own view, are strong points.
Brother Khan had a contribution to make on every sitting of Parliament. He was one of the people who was always prepared, and he was, in fact, during the period that he served in the Senate, someone who always placed the people in the forefront of his thinking. He brought with him his vast experience of the public service and also service to the community. So Brother Khan was, in fact, someone who you could rely on bringing a balance, someone who you didn't have to think about whether they were having a partisan view. He was very impartial in whatever he said, thought, and did.
we had touched on the question of the Constitution, the independent senators, and it still continues to be a big bug in Trinidad and Tobago, in our country, the question of the Constitution, because when you reflect back, our first independent Constitution, the second one of the Republican Constitution, there was hardly any people's participation. And one gets the opinion that something was made for you. And being people as we are, and especially our young people, I don't think they ever accepted that. The question of not being part of it, and even the practice of governments, I stress governments, that came in putting this their programs together, was highly centralist and highly autocratic, so to speak. So the question of democracy, of course, we had it expressed in elections, good, but the question of being reflected in practice still remains a very, very elusive hope of our country.
Over the years, Noble Can would have embraced the rich art forms that were nurtured in Lavant Hill: steel pan, calypso, and mass. He's an avid enthusiast of the steel pan, playing the tenor pan, and having a fondness for community orchestras, desperados, renegades, city syncopators, and the Trinidad All-Stars, adding that he places All-Stars on a pedestal.
My steel band was City Syncopators. My sisters and them will choose the band up the hill, Despers. Good? But City Syncopators was a new boy on the block. Good, and you had, you know, from that you could have, well, the steel band that had awe was really All-Stars. Good? That was the... There was Casablanca. Across the road, there was, over the hill was Tokyo. Then later on you had Highlanders, Bertie, Kim Loy, right? Kim Loy brother Joseph is married to one of my cousins. He recently passed away in Canada. You know, so that there is that connection too on the steel band, right? The Calypsonians too, because the area had many Calypsonians. This girl again, so is of your sister. My singing Sandra. Noah well. Noah in her mother's womb, so to speak. And So that connection is there, the Calypsonian connection too. Some are still around, the young generation. Keep a healthy connections with them too. Also too with the Best Village, the area. We used to be a judge in Best Village for quite some time. So you have that kind of connection. In the area in Lavant Hill, our family and even up the hill always had a sort of respect among the community. And even I myself, good, in the area, though you would hear bad boys and you hear the shootings and things, you know, and you would hear, they will tell you about who passed away and who shot, and all children who you know and grew up with, you know. So it lived in a very sad state too. But overall, the area is not a bad area. It is not worse than any other area.
He has been a noted masquerader, having played King of the Band and having won Individual of the Year with the portrayal of Montezuma from the band of Mexico, led by Harold Saldina, his brother-in-law. He also enjoyed close friendships with renowned mass band designer George Bailey, and those he termed the other avant-garde thinkers and producers of the mass of the time. Married to Mai Moon, the couple has four sons, with three grandsons and one granddaughter. As he started in life, Noble Can continues to call Lavant Hill home and maintains deep roots in the community. Like his father, he too is well-traveled, visiting Palestine, Israel, South Korea, Argentina, the United Kingdom, Canada, the USA, Venezuela, Guyana, and throughout the Caribbean.
I still hold that within your own self, good, that respect that you are supposed to have, not an arrogance, it must emerge out of a deep spiritual feeling, and I think that is where that over the years, good, my own upbringing had plenty to do with it. The people who I communicated with, good, were my parents, good, my friends, my teachers, good, all who I came in contact with, my work environment had plenty to do with it. My wife and family had plenty to do with it. So these are some of the things, you know, that I think will have impact in both ways. You know, it might be selfless, it might be difficult to express, but a question of true love in a selfless way, not in a selfish way.
It is perhaps a combined perspective of viewing different societies, believing steadfastly in an underprivileged community, appreciating indigenous cultural art forms, being conscientious in his profession, and having strong religious values that allow former independent senator Noble Khan to positively impact the shaping of legislation in Trinidad and Tobago as brought before the Senate. And like his name, Noble Khan did this service selflessly. Living up to his name, Brother Noble Salahaddin Ahmad Khan.
Many years ago, a man had a hammer, used to follow him to and fro. He used to use it upon a pan, or sometimes a stupid man, all in the savannah, never miss panorama. One day the old hammer just disappeared. Oh, some say that it vanished.